Hello, students. Today we're going to be going over the respiratory tract structures of the fetal pig, as well as the cardiovascular structures. We'll point out some vessels and the structures that go with these systems. First, appreciate that the nose is the first part. The nasal cavity is going to be the first part of our respiratory system. And we're not going to be able to see in here, but we can see the hard palate, which is the floor of the nasal cavity, and the soft palate, which is the posterior floor of the nasal cavity. And here we can also see the epiglottis, which this is that cartilaginous flap that will cover the trachea, the larynx, and actually prevent food from entering when we swallow. So this is very, very important. And so if we're going to label this, this would be my epiglottis. And of course, in here, and it is very hard to see up close, but we actually have the vocal folds right here. And so that will be the entrance to the trachea. Just as a review, remember our esophagus sits directly behind that and food will go over when we swallow. This covers the trachea and food goes over and down posteriorly. So that's our epiglottis, hard palate, soft palate, nares, and nasal cavity within. And so appreciate, as air flows through the nasal cavity, we have important things happening. We have humidification, so it's getting moistened, it's getting warmed, and it's getting filtered by all those nasal hairs that are in there and the turbinates that are in there as well. And so as air moves down, it's going to go through the pharynx, which we have a nasopharynx, oropharynx, and laryngeal pharynx, and then we're going to move into the larynx. And this is best visualized on our pig down here in the cervical area. So this firm structure right here, this is the larynx. Another name for this might be the voice box. And so the folds that we cannot see here actually vibrate as air moves through there, and then we create sound, and we modify that sound with our mouth and the movement of our lips and tongue and whatnot. But this right here is our larynx. And remember, just inferior to that and anterior to the trachea, we have our thyroid. This looks like a little brown ball. If you were to flatten this out a little bit, it looks more like a butterfly that kind of goes around the trachea. But here we see the entrance, entrance into the lower respiratory tract. We have our larynx and we have our trachea. And we can always identify this by these rings here. And remember, these are C-shaped to allow for the food bolus to move posteriorly behind that in the esophagus, which is right here, and to keep that airway open. And as the trachea extends inferiorly into the thoracic cavity, it's going to divide up into our main stem bronchi and then smaller and smaller bronchi into our lungs. So right here, we can actually see lung tissue right here. This will be our right lungs, because remember, we're looking down on our fetal pig. And over here, and actually I'm gonna have to cut into the, move this tissue here, we've got our left pleural cavity, and there are our left lungs. So if I'm going to label the trachea, we're gonna put that in those rings right there. I'm gonna take this larynx and put it in this big box, this firm structure here. And then for my right lungs, again, that's gonna be on this side here, and my left lungs will be over here. Now remember, we have multiple cavities within the thoracic cavity, so this whole structure is my thoracic cavity. I've got my pleural cavities, which surround the lungs, and I have my pericardial cavity. And when we made our incision to open this fetal pig up, I actually had to cut through the pericardial sac here. So this is part of that. So if I lay this over, this would be that pericardial cavity, and within that, I have my heart. So here you can see the heart, and it is a little bit difficult to see all the structures of the heart, but you can actually see the pulmonic trunk. This will be the right side of the heart here. That's gonna be my right auricle. Left side of the heart here, so those are my coronary vessels. Left auricle and left ventricle. So right ventricle, left ventricle. And when we do our heart dissection, again, when you orient yourself, you're gonna put this in front of you so you can find these structures. Okay, so here is the fetal pig heart. Just below the lungs and the heart, we have a muscular structure that separates our thoracic cavity and the abdominal pelvic cavity. This structure is the diaphragm. And remember, this is going to be vitally important in the movement of air into and out of the lungs, which we call ventilation. So I'm going to put a little label here for the diaphragm. And again, I did have to cut through that when we were preparing this fetal pig. And I'll put a little label here in the heart as well. We will do a large heart dissection for your individual structures. So in your book, it may go through the structures as well, but we're gonna do it in a larger heart so you can see all of the structures. And then of course, labeling my pericardial sac, this would be over the top of that. So I'll just pull it over so you can see. And again, I had to cut through that. And then another structure that goes with the cardiovascular system is going to be the spleen. So when we look at the spleen, this is over here. It's in the abdominal pelvic cavity. It's gonna be next to the stomach. Okay, they actually share some vessels there. And so we have the spleen here and it's elongated. This is different than in humans. And in humans, it's compact. So that's a distinction we want to make. And so I'll put the label here for that. Additionally, there are some vessels I do want you to know about since we're talking about the cardiovascular system. When we talk about fetal circulation, remember we have some unique structures. This is what we call the umbilical vein. So remember, this was attached to my umbilicus, and this is our blood flow from the placenta that will come, will actually pick up nutrients and oxygen, and this is gonna go into fetal circulation and deliver this oxygen and nutrients to the fetus. And here we have our umbilical arteries. Remember, arteries go away from the heart, so these are coming away from the fetal heart, and these are going towards the placenta, and they're bringing waste. So that will be exchanged with the placenta and mom will carry away that waste and take care of that. And we have this because the fetus is not going to be doing a lot of its own metabolism. Mom is gonna be helping with that. So this is our cardiovascular system for and respiratory system for the fetal pig.